Okay, so today I'm going to insert the Medtronic Enlite CGM and the Dexcom G5 CGM. And I started out using the Enlite, and I had that for about a year, and it was not accurate at all, and just pretty much drove me crazy. And since it links right to my MiniMed pump, it would shut it down if it was saying I was low, and then I would wake up and I would be, you know, super high, because it would say that I was like in the 60s. I'd wake up and test it and I was actually like 160, so it'd be like 100 off. And I was going away on vacation, and I knew I wanted a good CGM, and online, after talking to a bunch of people, I decided to try Dexcom, and that's now my favorite. Well, since I have both, I'm going to do a trial so that everyone can see what the difference is, and I'm going to put them around the same area, and we will see how it works. Okay, so first we're gonna insert the Medtronic Enlite. Now, they give you these little stickers. Excuse my cat, Luna. These little stickers are what hold it in place. This is all part of the Medtronic that drives me crazy, is the actually putting in the CGM. This is the inserter. And this is actually the transmitter right here, the little clamp shape. Now, you wear it for, it says 7 days, and then it'll let you know that you need to change it. So after the 7 days, you have to plug this back into the charger, and it does a quick charge, and you can, or you don't even have to charge it. I think you use it for 14 days without the quick charge, but that drove me crazy also. All right, so in here are the sensors. They come like this. So the inserter, you're gonna hold these two right here in the front. Just hold them like your fingers. It's been a while since I did this. Go this way. All right, so hold them like that. And the green oblong sensor part goes right here. You slide down, you don't push hard enough till it clicks, and you pull up. And now there's the needle. It's primed, ready to go. Okay. So I'm gonna set that to the side. We're gonna clean the area. I'm gonna pick over here. Let it dry a little bit. Okay, where these little arrow marks are, that is in a horizontal spot of where the needle is. So that kind of gives you an area of where the needle will be. Also, when you're putting this in, you kind of want to go with the curve of the body. So instead of going this way, you may want to go up and down, because it's more flat, instead of trying to go around a bend. So I'm going to go up and down. I'm going to go right here, and I'm going to count to three. When I push the green button, it's going to prime it. Look at him. It's gonna prime it, and then when I release the green button is when it's actually going to put it in me. All right, so ready, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so now the needle's in, the sensor's in, and I'm gonna wait. I've learned over time, it's easier to remove it if you wait about a minute. And once you wait about a minute, the adhesive is a little bit better, because when I pulled this inserter out, I've also pulled the sensor out about a million times. Okay, so you pull in, push in the green button again. You pull it straight out. Needle's still in, so you hold right here, and you're gonna pull the needle out. Now the sensor's in. Now what they tell you to do is you release this sticky part back here. Easier said than done. And you rub so that it sticks better. Now these little stickers that they give you, I use two at a time. Get them out. Okay, So it's labeled one and then labeled two. So you remove number one first. And what they tell you to do is they tell you to put it halfway on this plastic piece and halfway on your skin. Rub, 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 rub. Release. Okay, now you take the little clam-shaped transmitter and you're going to push it till it clicks, like so. And this piece, you peel off the stickiness. And you don't have to pull real tight because it actually makes it not work as well if you pull it real tight. Gentle is the key. All right, then the next step is the sticky stuff. Again, remove number one, about halfway. And this plastic piece here is really hard. It's not like the other sticky stuff. And if you don't kind of put this sticker underneath it, it will cut you. It's cut me a million times if I didn't put it in the right area. So I kind of put the sticker part underneath there so that there's a barrier between that and my skin. All right, so the Enlite is inserted. And now you would go to your pump. And you go here and go to sensor. Turn the sensor on. And you go back, you go to link to sensor, new sensor. And now it's connecting to the new sensor. So in 2 hours, it's gonna alert me and I'm gonna have to give a calibration blood count. All right, so the Enlite is in. Onto the Dexcom G5. All right, so these come in packs like this, and they're already self-contained, all ready to go. Your transmitter comes in a box like this. I just had to use a new transmitter because this transmitter lasts 3 months. After you use it for 3 months, it no longer works and you have to get another new transmitter. Now, so this one, you just keep recharging this last 3 months. The cool thing about this is, and it's not recommended by Dexcom, but I've learned that once you insert this and the 7 days are up, you can then, before it shuts down, you say that you're putting in a new sensor and you restart it and it can last, and I've had them last a month. So that's amazing and it saves money. All right, and it's completely accurate for the whole month. All right, so now we're gonna put this around the same area. Since I do wear it for about a month and I can wear it for that long, I try and make it last as long as I can. With the Enlite, I don't put any adhesive barrier on it to make it stick better just because it'll barely last 6 or 7 days. That's it. So the normal sticky stuff is okay. But I use SkinTac, which is a liquid adhesive, so that the sticky stuff stays on better. And it's about a circle. So you make about there. You let that dry. I should have used alcohol wipes and I just realized I forgot. Okay, so while that's drying, we're gonna take this out of the package. Completely different insertion process. And I've now used this for 3 months. I've never accidentally pulled out the sensor. I've never had an issue with the insertion process. With the Enlite, Medtronic Enlite, I probably pulled out a dozen or more. I mean, literally more than a dozen. Medtronic is really good with giving you replacements. If you call and you say, look, the sensor got pulled out while I was insertion, they'll give you a new one. But it is just a pain when you're trying to put it in. And I've actually had to replace one of these within the year because it was getting stuck and wouldn't release the needle. All right. So this is what it looks like, and the needle's gonna go through the center part. Now they tell you that you need to have it vertical instead of horizontal. I'm going with the same theory that it's because the body is shaped that certain way. And when you put the adhesive on, you want to make sure that the needle is going to be placed in the hole where you don't have the sticky stuff. All right, so the first thing you do is you remove this. This is the safety lock so that the plunger doesn't go down without you wanting it to. So you let go. They say you can keep this to remove the transmitter from the place when you're done. You don't need to, but you can if you want to. Straighten these out. And you just pick one side and peel it off. Pick the other side, peel it off. And I guess technically you should remove the plunger safety before you do that so that it doesn't. All right, so we're gonna put this in, place it on here, and you rub the sticker, which is already applied. And then you're gonna push the white plunger down all the way down. You're gonna hear two clicks. And you can squeeze right here. And then you're gonna pull this up, two clicks. And you rock it back and forth, actually. Squeeze those two buttons and rock it back and forth. And then you're going to put the transmitter in. This is so awkward for me because I'll tell you why in about 2 seconds. All right, so small side in first. Use this to squeeze it down to two clicks, and then you twist this. And it comes off. That's inserted, and you're good to go. Now, I'll tell you why I had a little issue putting that in. I always put the Dexcom in the back of my arm. And you don't feel it. It stays. I work out all the time. The sweat, everything, it's perfect there. And I can put it in myself. I put my arm down and I squeeze it. And I can use one hand. And gravity, when you squeeze the two buttons to let go of this, you squeeze the two buttons and you lean down and it falls off. There's no way of doing the Medtronic Enlite on your arm without extra help, because I've tried and squeeze that and to pull the needle, you can't do it. I've had to have help. So to be accurate as to doing these the exact same way, I put them in the same spot and showed you exactly how they are. So to me, this looks ridiculous and is a lot harder to put in. This is just like one step. The sticker is already there and you're good to go. And what I do when I have my arm is I order, they're called Griff Grips, and I'll put the website down below. And you can get all different kinds of patterns and shapes and things. But these are the cat ones I got for Halloween time. And they fit and you get the cut that you want and it goes right around. So when I wear it on my arm, I do that. And to be honest, this is only gonna last about 6 or 7 days. So when this one comes off, I will put the kitty cat on here because this baby's gonna last a while. So next step is I have to go on my phone to my app for the G5 and I will pull up the Dexcom and it says transmitter not found, only because I had to get a new transmitter. So now I'm going to start that and it's going to start my new transmitter. So once it finds that, then I'm going to go back and I'm going to hit that I put in the sensor, and then it's gonna do a 2-hour calibration also. Now with the Medtronic, once the 2 hours starts to beep on my pump, I'll have to give one blood test and put it in. The Dexcom G5, you have to put in 2 calibrations. So once that all starts, we'll videotape and I will go throughout the week of any errors, any perfect accuracies, I can't speak, and see what happens. So here's to the trial of the Enlite CGM from Medtronic and the Dexcom G5 CGM. Okay, so what I had to do was, because it's a new transmitter, I went to transmitter, had to pair new. And it shows you this, and you take the box, make sure you save the box. I mean, you can put actual the transmitter SN number by hand, but it's easy to do this. So you take photo, you line it up with the barcode, gives you a little check mark. So now it's connecting the iPhone to the transmitter. So it'll take about 30 minutes. Once that happens, then I will sync my sensor to it, and then within 2 hours we'll calibrate and we'll be good to go. It's been 2 hours and I've got the alert for meter BG now. Okay, so 129. It's gonna go over here and it's going to say, do I want to update the sensor? And you hit yes and okay. Meter BG now. Still wants it. Okay, so we're good. So now we can go to the graph on air and it's just starting. Okay, so I'm going to test the first one. Okay, so 136. So you go over and you push the green circle and you hit 136, save. And it asks if it's correct and you hit save. Now you have to do a second blood test. Now, what I do is I actually take one from the other hand. It's never been told to me to do that. That's just what I've done. And I have great accuracy, so I'm not going to change the way I do it. All right, so now the other hand. So now you go into here. And you hit 137, save. Is it correct? Yes. Now it gives me my numbers 136 and it'll start the graph. So now it's 740 and I have both of them going at the same time. So let's pull up the Medtronic graph and see what it says. I do not want to update it. Okay, because my meter linked, so it was asking if I wanted to update it. All right, so we go over to the graph and Medtronic is reading 123 at 7. Wow, my clock's a little messed up, so it's 7:33. It's actually 7:40, and the Dex is reading 136. All right. Okay, so it's 8:55. And around 8:35, I got a beeping alert from my pump saying that it was a weak signal. Now, I've kept my pump in the exact same spot, which is on the side of my bra, since I inserted both sensors and since I calibrated. Now I'm getting this alert and it says lost sensor, and it's 8:55. And I've been trying to link up to CareLink, but it keeps saying that sign in has failed, but I know my username and password because I go on CareLink. I just went on CareLink to make sure. So it's saying that it's having a temporarily not responding. Please try again later. So for the lost sensor, I'm gonna go I'm going to go down to sensor and I'm going to go to link to sensor and I'm going to go find lost sensor. So in 15 minutes it's going to alert and then I'm going to have to give a BG reading. All right, so let's go look at Dexcom, and the Dexcom says 112, and there's the reading, so I'll be back. Okay, so it's night time, September 27th.
This is the first night going to sleep with the Enlite Medtronic sensor and the Dexcom sensor. So right before I turned this on, I checked and the Enlite was saying 139 and the Dexcom was saying 175, and I checked my blood and it was 131. So I did correct with 0.2 units of insulin because I was higher than I should be. But for accuracy points, the Medtronic wins for tonight. So that's night one. And I will see you guys all in the morning. Night, night. I'm about 24 hours from the time that I inserted the Medtronic Enlite CGM and the Dexcom G5 CGM. So right now I'm going to take a look and see what we've got going on. All right, so on the Dexcom it shows 125. On the MiniMed says uploader weak signal. Now I have to have the uploader, which is the little black piece, to connect it Bluetooth wise through my pump and the phone so I can read it on here. And it's been saying this on and off all day today, and I will show you that I literally have the little black piece right next to me, so it can't really get much closer. And I plugged it in just to make sure it was fully charged, even though I fully charged it yesterday just for this experiment. But I do have it here, and I have my pump in my pocket right here. So all three are fairly close, and I'm not sure why it's not. I will, after I do this, I will try and sync it again and see maybe why I can figure out why it's not working. Okay, but it can't be a Bluetooth issue because the Dexcom runs through Bluetooth, and that's working also. Okay. So I'm going to go test my finger. Well, we can actually see what Medtronic's number is by looking at the graph. And Medtronic's number says 141. And that's 324. And 324, it says 124. So now we're going to test the blood and we're going to see what the meter says. And testing. It says 104. Can you read that? 104. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to calibrate the Medtronic Enlite, and I'm also going to calibrate the Dexcom. Now, I only calibrate three times a day. First thing in the morning, which I did this morning, mid-afternoon, and then right before bed. Okay, so I'm going to hit act, and I'm going to go to sensor, calibrate, 104, yes. Okay, it's beeping like that because technically it's lower than my recommended number. All right, so go to the Dexcom. I hit this right here. I'm going to put 104, save. So the Dexcom kind of takes the what the number was originally and what I just put in, and it automatically lowers it. So it says 110, and on the Medtronic, still says 141. It'll eventually change itself from the calibration. And that's what's going on right now. So I'll talk to you. I'm still having issues with the Medtronic MiniMed Connect working. I've done everything. I actually have deleted the app 2 times now and reloaded it. This is me reloading it again. I'm going to put in my information here. It's telling me to push the button on the side of the uploader for 3 seconds until the blue light blinks, which I've going to do it again, but I've done this a bunch of times. Okay, so there is the blue light blinking. Hit search, and I'm going to put it directly on the phone because it just keeps saying that it needs to be in close range and it needs to have the blue light blinking, which... Okay, so it just says uploader not found. Make sure uploader is in range and blue light is flashing. So I was just folding some laundry in my bedroom, and a lot of times after I make breakfast, I'll put my, insulin in for whatever I've just eaten, and then I will take it off and I'll just do a couple little, things around the house, not for very long, but it's just something I do from time to time. And I was just about to go put my pump back on, and I heard a beeping noise coming from my pump, which is in my bedroom, which is literally just a couple feet. And I checked my Dexcom, and my Dexcom is showing 156. It's 11:46. I haven't used the Medtronic Enlite in probably 8 months, maybe now. But I've been using the Dexcom, and I have not had any errors of like losing signal, by doing this. And when it started beeping, I just remembered how this used to annoy me with the Medtronic. So here in the bathroom, I look and there's, the alert thing. So let's see what it says. It says weak signal. So it was telling me that I guess I was too far from it. So then when I try and read, it's saying weak signal. So I've lost, whatever my blood glucose would be. And like I said, my phone was over here with me, which is one thing. I always manage to have my phone with me. And even still, like I will have left my phone on the nightstand and, go out in the kitchen and do a couple things and come back, and I've never had a weak signal from that. So that's just one thing I've noticed. This is day 3, Thursday, September 29th. Signing out. It is Wednesday, September 28th. So I just looked at my Dexcom. My Dexcom was reading. Dexcom is reading 139. And then I tested my blood and the meter said 142. And I went on my pump to see what it said, and it said weak signal. So the Medtronic is saying weak signal right now. And the Dexcom was reading 139 and my blood sugar was 142. Not quite sure why the Medtronic was saying weak signal. The only thing I think of is I possibly had unhooked it quick and literally just went pee in the bathroom, so it wasn't very long at all, and I'm not sure if that created the weak signal. Let's check what it says now. Actually, now it's saying, I don't know if you can read it, it's saying 154 going up. Not sure why. But I do know that I unhook lots of times with my Dexcom, in and out of the house. Even like in the morning, I will go unhook, cook my breakfast, come back. Just something I do, because I don't like to get completely dressed in the morning. So instead of have it hanging down, I'll just unhook it and go, cook breakfast, and then I'll come back and I'll hook up and put my insulin in to eat. And I usually do not have a weak signal or any kind of error like that. But that's night number two. Tomorrow I'm going to take a nice long hot bath, and we'll see what happens there with accuracy on both of them. And also throughout this week, I'm going to keep taking pictures and video of what the CGM and the adhesiveness and, you know, how it's holding up and what it looks like. And then I usually go to the gym Monday through Friday, and I weightlift and I do cardio at least about hour and a half to 2 hours at the gym a day. I sweat like a pig, so that'll help also noticing, you know, how it holds up. But I did injure my neck Saturday, and I went to the chiropractor and they told me to at least let it rest until Friday. So Friday I will be taking my little GoPro to the gym and showing you guys what happens and the readings from there. So it is night three, September 29th at 12:32 a.m. I just took my last meter reading, and I checked the Dexcom, and the Dexcom said 115, and I checked, it says weak signal. I have calculated every time I've gotten a weak signal, and I will post that later, but it's been a lot today. And then I tested on the meter, and the meter said 127. So I calibrated both. Middle of the parking lot. Driving down the road, I wonder if you know. I'm trying so hard not to get caught up now, but you're just so cool. Run your hands through your hair, absent-minded. It's September 30th at 12:09, and I'm sitting in the parking lot of the gym about to go in. I'm going to check the number for the Dex first. It says 139 straight across. And I wear a flip belt when I'm at the gym. So I have that in here. Is my meter. My pump, not my meter. If I can get it out. And it says 122. So I'm going to check. The usual, test my blood before I go into the gym. And it's 139. I'm gonna calibrate both of them now, only because my pump was saying earlier that by 12:35 I need to put a meter reading in. So we'll calibrate it. Yeah, so I feel like a complete fool doing this at the gym. However, one thing I noticed while working out is with the Dexcom, I have my phone hooked up to my headphones, and I can get an alert or a beep right away through the headphones and know Dexcom is working good. If I don't have the Connect with me, which I don't, it's a pain to carry extra something with you, I have to lift up my shirt, dig in my flip belt, pull out my pump, and see what my number is. And when I have my headphones on, I cannot hear the alert. Yes, there's a vibration, but that's only if I'm on threshold and not if I'm too high. So far, the Dex is winning at the gym. Hasn't lost signal, hasn't had any issues. and it's right at my hands and in my ears, the headphones. Signing off.
Just leaving the gym, so it's time to see what the numbers are. I did leg day. It is now 140, and I did squats and, you know, all variations of legs, and then I did 4 miles on the bike. The Dexcom never lost signal, never had an issue, and like I said when I was riding the bike, that I have the headphones and I usually have my cell phone tucked into my pants or shorts, so I always have it with me, and it's reading 159 straight across. In order to get to my pump, I have to dig under my shirt and dig out the flip belt. Okay, which is a pain if you're in the gym and you're practically stripping. And it says 170 with an arrow going up. So let's see what it is. And yes, I washed my hands and all this right before. Alright, so I will not correct for that because I usually go up when I lift, so it will drop back down, so I'm not going to correct. So in an hour or so, we'll check what the numbers are on the Dexcom and Enlite and see how they do. Bye!
It is September 30th. Well, actually, I guess, no, it's September 30th. It's like 1:47. It's a late night. And it's night 4. And I just tested my blood and it's 118. I checked the Dex and it was 123. And the Enlite was 125. And I just calibrated both of them for 118. I went to the gym today and I also was outside in the heat sweating, watching a parade and doing that. So see how, oh, and I took a bath again today. So we'll see how the tape and everything holds up. And tomorrow I plan on going swimming and we'll see how the Dexcom and the Medtronic Enlite do while being away from them. Just a little bit while I'm in the water and see if the readings are still good or see if they lose signal easily. And that's about it for now. Just feel it.
Medtronic Connect, you would need to go on their CareLink website and look. And I'm not sure if it's actually real time. I think it's kind of live. The Dexcom is real time. The other thing is, with the Dexcom G5, you get the receiver also. Usually, if I'm just swimming in the neighborhood pool or a friend's pool, I don't bring the receiver with me, but I brought this just to show you guys. I got the Dexcom to go on vacation in the Bahamas, and I knew I'd be snorkeling and be in the water, and kind of scared me. And I knew the Medtronic, I couldn't do that because I wasn't going to take my pump in the water to know my numbers. So I got a waterproof bag, and I put the receiver in a plastic bag with some Smarties, and I had clipped this part to my bathing suit and this around my neck, and I actually went snorkeling all over the Bahamas for hours, and I could just push the button and I didn't lose signal at all, and it would tell me what my numbers were. So that worked out, and it made for carefree, well, as much as carefree as you can, diabetes vacation, and I wouldn't have been able to go snorkeling like that and have peace of mind if I didn't have the Dexcom. So that's a plus for that. And it is now 12:28. And I'm gonna go swimming, and we'll keep checking in and see what the Enlite says and the Dexcom. Just got out of the pool, and I heard it beeping. Of course, it's stopped beeping now. The Medtronic Enlite has lost sensor, so it went from weak signal to lost sensor, and it was beeping. And this says signal loss. Weak signal. And 152. So we'll see how long it takes to catch up. 153. And something. Because normally I swim in the pool here and I have my phone under the towel and I don't lose signal or with the Dexcom. And like I said earlier, my friends or my husband or whoever has the phone can look and see what my numbers are. But I usually wear the Dexcom on my arm, so my arm is not under the water 100% of the time, which is probably why this time I've lost sensor on the Dexcom, and normally I don't because I have it on my stomach only for this experiment because I couldn't insert the Enlite. So they both lost signal. Just got out of the pool, and I heard it beeping. Of course, it stopped beeping now. The Medtronic Enlite has lost sensor, so it went from weak signal to lost sensor, and it was beeping. And this says signal loss. So let's see here if it'll catch up. Weak signal. So we'll see how long it takes to catch up. 153. And something. Because normally I swim in the pool here and I have my phone under the towel and I don't lose signal or with the Dexcom. And like I said earlier, my friends or my husband. 117 at 153 to switch to 154. And the Medtronic says lost sensor still. So we'll see what it says and what it takes. And also, I will test it. Actually, you know what? Duh. I think it's a big signal. Since it says lost signal, I have to go in to find lost sensor. And then it's going to be ready in about 15 minutes of beeping, so we'll see what it says. Oh. Oh. It was just telling me because I put my meter in. That's what my brother tells me. So now it's warming up.
Everybody, so it's still October 1st, and today was the day that went swimming and sunbathed for a couple hours, and then it is now 7:30, so I showered after swimming, and then I decided to go out to dinner, and then we went bowling. So I'll show you what the Dexcom and the Enlite looks like right now. Now I'll tell you, yesterday the Enlite kept bothering me with, I don't know if you remember me saying when I put them in that there is, this sticker here is very hard. So it kind of digs and cuts in you. Well, that's what it started doing yesterday. So got back from bowling, and when I was bowling, I kept getting this like rubbing, irritating annoyance, and I guess it's actually this. It's pretty much, I hope not completely out. Sure seems that way. Here's the Dex. Now, if you do remember when I did insert, I did put the skin tack underneath it, only because I knew I was going to be wearing it probably for about a month because it lasts so long. But I haven't had a problem before I used the skin tack for it to last at least 2 weeks. So I did put that on only to last the month. But I'm kind of worried about this. It says 166. So hopefully it's still intact there. 164, sorry, it says. Hopefully it's still intact and we can continue with the experiment and see what happens. But it is kind of bothering me because I don't know if you've ever had one of, you know, worn the sensor or even the sight before and it gets loose. It really jiggles around, and tomorrow's Sunday, but Monday will be another gym day, and I just know that it's gonna rub, and I don't know. We'll see. I'm going to hold on as long as I can until it says that I have to change it because it's not working or it completely, you know, errors out and it's pointless for me to wear. The last video, which is October 1st, and it is around 9 o'clock now, was at 7:30. And I was showing you guys, hear the beeping, showing you guys how the adhesive to the Enlite was starting to come off, and it was like pretty much lifted after swimming today and bowling. I wear my pump a lot of times in my bra, different areas, and I hide it in spots. So I have it in the flip belt, and in my flip belt, I don't wear it around my waist. I wear it up here, so I kind of conceal it, and I don't look like I have like a tumor on my hip or bigger hips than I already got. So I forgot how when the Medtronic Enlite sensor has an error or has an alert, it starts beeping. Well, I can't just go on my phone and shut it off. I have to go get to my pump and hit the buttons. Well, when you're out in public, I can't, you know, I don't always have the opportunity to go run in the bathroom. Beeping. So I'm at the grocery store, and the whole time I'm trying to go in aisles where no one's seeing me, and I'm trying to like go like this, and people think I'm like, you know, got bugs or something, I don't know, like I'm digging in here, and it's still beeping. And then I'm hoping to God, because I'm trying to feel that I'm pushing, you know, the escape and the act button, which are the buttons I push, and I don't push some, you know, other button. And I was able to push it a couple times, but it still kept beeping and beeping and beeping. And I'm in line. People are looking at me like I got a bomb. I don't know what they think I got. And now that I'm in line and it's beeping, I can't be digging in here. You know, if it was easy to get to, I might be able to just like kind of pull it out my hip or something and just do it. But it's literally in the flip belt, in a pocket, in my boobs. So it was very, very, very annoying. I'm gonna show you what it's beeping for. Right after, so before I left to go to the grocery store, it was having the error. So then while I was in the car, it asked for the blood glucose, meter glucose. So I calibrated it and gave it the right thing. And I got in the grocery store and just instantly started beeping. Beeping, 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 beeping through the whole grocery store experience. So I get in the car and I dig it out and it says sensor error. And I hit the buttons and it says calibration error. I hit the buttons and it says meter BG. So now it wants me to give another calibration. So while I was in the car driving, I gave in. I was driving while I did it, but we're diabetics and we multitask. So I did that. And I drove home from the grocery store, which is not very far at all. And it's beeping again. So I'm going to show you what it says now. I don't even know what it says, really, but let's see. Without showing you all my goodies. Okay. So this is what I would have had to do in the grocery store just to shut it up. It's not the easiest thing on the planet. That's hooked. Okay. It says sensor error. So I hit it again. It's gonna say calibration error. And it's gonna say BG now. This is now the third time I've had to calibrate it, which means it's not working. And it's soon gonna tell me to change the sensor. So I pretty much think this is the end of the Enlite. I will put in my blood glucose one more time just so that we make sure we've tried to make it last as long as it possibly could. Today is Saturday, October 1st, and I put them in Tuesday, so we're at Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. It's lasted 5 days. October 1st still, and it is now 9:40, and the Enlite just died. It's not working at all. So my reasoning behind that is because it did just get so loose from just wearing it. You know, the sticky stuff has come off. So I'm going to remove it. So as of 9:40 on October 1st, the Enlite is no more with. So yeah, it's like barely in there. Here's something interesting. So here is
the sensor that was in me. Now, I feel like I'm just constantly negative with the Enlite, but I've had so many issues with it that I think me putting it back on has just relived all those issues. It's not necessarily only calibration issues, it's just all the things that go with it are complicated. Not complicated to use, because I'm very tech savvy, and that's not the issue. It's just, it doesn't seem to all mesh well together. So the Dexcom, you know, it just has the transmitter and then the app, and it has the receiver, but I strictly pretty much use the app unless I'm doing something that I need to use the receiver. I will use the receiver at nighttime as a second precaution next to my bed, but it just seems that it's accumulation of things that have kind of driven me as a love-hate relationship with the Enlite. So here's what I'm going to show you. I need to get to a darker background so maybe we can see. All right. The sensor, because of the insertion process, do you see how it's really bent up there? It's kind of like a upside down L, and then it kind of curves up. Well, it should be in you perfectly straight in order for the most accuracy and, you know, no errors and stuff like that. Now, here's what I'm going to try and show you. It is very, very fine. It's hard to show with the... It's very fine. And not very big, I might add. And it goes straight in. This is a sensor from the last time I wore my Dexcom, which was the... Hang on, that's the Enlite telling me. Here's an error. There's an error because it's out of my skin. But this was the transmitter that has just expired because it lasts 3 months. So I saved it for this experiment because I knew that my Dexcom would last more than, you know, the 6 or 7 days that the Enlite would last. So do you see how much bigger, it's really hard to tell, how much bigger the sensor part is that goes in you? And it goes in at like a 45 degree angle. To me, that really makes a difference with errors. I mean, it's going in at a 45 degree angle. It's never been bent. I've used it for 3 months straight. This one here is crusty because I wore it for 1 month. I didn't take it off. I literally wore it for 1 month. And I think it all has to do with the insertion process being so simple, and it's never been bent, and I haven't had an error issue. I can probably tell you I used the Enlites for over a year, and maybe 5 times it was perfectly straight, and that's a stretch. I mean, it's probably maybe 2 or 3 times it was perfectly straight. There's always been a bend or a curve in it, and I'm telling you it's from the insertion process. And this is more like a wire feel. Can you hear that? Today is Wednesday, October 5th. I started the Dexcom Enlite experiment on Tuesday, September 27th. I will have to say, I know a lot on the videos when I was taping that I seemed very negative or one-sided, negative towards the Enlite and one-sided for the Dexcom. The issue is I had such a love-hate relationship with my Enlite before, and I haven't worn it in about 8 months. So by me putting it back on, it was just like every time something happened that used to drive me crazy from it before brought back
all the horrible memories of it. So I really did try to view both as if I had no swing one way or the other. In my opinion, the Dexcom is the only choice for me, even though I do have a Medtronic pump that I use. There is so much that goes along with the Enlite, and it really kind of gets all messed up, and it just causes for more of a hassle. And for me, with this disease, there's so much hassle to begin with. I have to constantly remember to bring things. I have to plan, you know, if I'm going to just go leave the house, I have to make sure I have my meter. I have to make sure I have everything that I need, you know, a snack, a candy if I need it. So to me, anything that I can wear that is going to help me and not cause me to have extra stress and bring extra things, and I want the least. So I did start using the Medtronic Enlite Connect in the experiment, and I just, to me, it's a really dumb concept on their part. I know it only works on the iPhones. So if you have an Android, you can't, and you have to have the little transmitter part. Well, it's called uploader, sorry. My terminology for these videos may not always be correct, but it's because I'm just winging it on the fly. So the uploader, you have to carry that with you. So now I gotta carry this little thing. It has to be within 6 feet of my pump. You know, I have to have 20 feet from the pump to the CGM. And now it's causing me to even, you know, plan out outfits and plan things I gotta wear just to carry all this extra stuff. And for that uploader, that's not covered by the insurance. It does not come as part of the Enlite system. You have to buy that separately. When I bought it, it was on sale. I think, if I'm remembering correctly, it was $200 when it first came out. And I got it around Christmas time, and it was half off for their Christmas special they had, and it was $100. And I did recently look for this experiment, and it was $100 right now. It's not covered by insurance, and it's optional. You don't have to have it, but the thing about that is that you can read your numbers on your phone. However, you can read your numbers on your phone, but you can't shut off the alerts, which in the video you saw me losing my mind because I had to dig in my bra to shut off the alerts. That drives me crazy. And especially if I'm like, I've been out to, you know, events where I had to be completely dressed up, and I have my pump taped in areas that I really can't get to. So I need to go to the bathroom when I have to put my insulin in, you know, and disrobe to do it. I do not have the ability at times to be out and having this beeping. And Gret, yes, I know you're going to say, well, you can silence it. But what's the point of silencing it then if I don't even know what's going on? Because I can't look on my phone. I'd have to pull my pump out to see if I got an alert if it's silenced. That's what drives me crazy. Like I said, the Dexcom G5 is literally my phone and my CGM. Now, I do have the receiver, and I use it in part of the experiment sometimes, just to see, you know, how it worked with everything, and it works good. Like I said, I use it for when I'm snorkeling or going to different areas where I can't have my phone on me and I'm not going to have my pump on me. So I can put my pump, you know, off to the side if I'm going to go do an event or something that I'm afraid to break my pump, or I'm going in the water or something like that. And then I can carry the receiver on me and I can know what my sugars are. This experiment wasn't so much for all accuracy. A lot of people were asking me, you know, I can't wait to see what the accuracy of the thing is. To be honest, this time, and I could do the experiment next week and the accuracy could be completely different. The accuracy for both was actually really good. I've had used the Medtronic before, and it was way off, like 100 points here or there. And the Dexcom for me has been fairly accurate for the most part every time I've used it. The Enlite did have a lot of weak signals, and I pretty much stopped counting at 40 weak signals. That was one of the other things that used to drive me crazy when I used the Enlite, was the weak signals, the lost sensors,
the calibration errors. And the reason behind, like, I can't just go walk away from my pump for a few seconds. Like, the one night I got up to go to the bathroom and I left my pump on the bed, went to the bathroom, came back, and had lost sensor. My bedroom has a bathroom connected to it. It should not do it that fast. It just makes for a constant monitoring and a constant pushing buttons on the pump when I'm trying to do less things as it is. The other thing negative with the Medtronic would be that the battery on the pump dies twice as fast because it's giving a constant reading, graphing it on the pump. I'm going to show you, I got an alert on my phone the other day that my Dexcom was about to end. So what you can do is right before it ends, you hit stop sensor. And then you act like you're inserting another sensor. This is not recommended by Dexcom, by the way. This is just something I've learned. And so it starts up the 2-hour process again, and you can actually end up wearing the Dexcom for longer than the week. I've worn it for a month, and the accuracy is awesome. So here is what it looks like now, which is we're on day 8. And I did put the little kitty cat sticker on it, and we're doing good. And the accuracy is great. Now, what I was going to say before was, I do know that when I used to use the Enlite, day 1 is usually not that accurate, and by day 5, it starts to error out. So I usually get maybe 5 to 6 days on the Enlite. The Dexcom day 1 is off also. It's not as accurate. It just takes a little bit of time for, you know, both of the CGMs to start calibrating and working good. But this is my experiment, and I hope you all enjoyed it. And next time, I'm going to do a day in the life of a type 1 diabetic. So hopefully you follow me, and you'll watch that. Bye-bye.